Happy holidays and welcome to another video in our How My Computer Works series. My name is Matt Bauer and this week's video will focus on more tips for using Microsoft Outlook. In case you missed my first video on Outlook, you can check it out by clicking the link below. In that video, I detailed three Outlook tips and here are three more. Number one, delete autocomplete entries. You've probably noticed that Outlook suggests previously typed email addresses as you type them into the To or CC fields. However, if you have mistyped an email address in the past, it will still suggest those. You can delete those suggestions very easily using your up and down arrow keys. These are located toward the lower right side of your keyboard. Simply highlight the email address you wish to remove and hit the delete key on your keyboard, which is located just above those arrow keys. This is also useful if you have a correctly typed yet undesirable email address in those suggestions. Number two, removing clutter in forwards. If you like to forward jokes, poems, or anything else really, it's best to clean up what you're sending before you send it. You may notice that when you receive email forwards, you frequently need to scroll down past several email addresses and headers to find the actual email itself. So why not make it easier on the people you're forwarding it to? All you have to do is highlight everything above the email content and delete it. So, when you want to forward something, just click the forward button, scroll down to the email content, click and drag to highlight all the unnecessary stuff above it, and hit the delete key or the backspace key on your keyboard. Now the people who receive it will not have to scroll all the way down to find what they're looking for. Number three, email signature. I've had some requests for this one, so here's how to create a signature for your emails. Go to Tools, Options, the Mail Format tab, Signatures. Now, if you have multiple email accounts set up in Outlook, this is where you can select the account that you want to associate the signature with. When you're ready, click New. Type a name for the signature. This should be something like Work or Home or Signature 1. Then click OK. Now you can create the signature in the space here. Just like any Word document or email, you can do things like choosing a font, changing the font size, bold or underlined text, and change the color of your text. It's up to you. When you have your signature just how you want it, click Save. Finally, you can choose to have the signature automatically added to new messages, replies and forwards, neither or both. When you've made your selections, click the OK button. Then OK again. Now, when you create a new message or reply to one, the signature you created will automatically be at the bottom of the email. To change the signature, go back into Tools, Options, Mail Format, Signatures. Make sure the signature that you want to change is selected. Then go ahead and make the changes the same way as when you created the signature. Then click Save when you're done. Then OK, and OK again. If you want to delete the signature, again, go back into Tools, Options, Mail Format, Signatures. Select the signature you wish to delete, then click Delete. You may have to confirm. When you're done, click OK, and OK again. There are, of course, many more features in Microsoft Outlook, and I will cover them in a future video. But if you have any training ideas, go ahead and send them to training@mycomputerworks.com, or just post them in the comments section below. My name is Matt Bauer. Have a happy and safe holiday, and we'll see you next time.